Hey RD family, and welcome back to my channel. If this is your first time seeing my face, go ahead and hit that subscribe button down below to join the RD family. And if you're not new here and you're already a subscriber, hey girl, it's good to see you. I'm glad to have you. So it's been almost 2 months, maybe a month since my last post. This is not a chapter two is still in the process. I'm still creating it, so it will be up in the near future, but I wasn't planning to post anything until I posted chapter two, but this came up, so, and it's very important to me, so I have to post this video. Just a few disclaimers before I actually get into the video. I'm not gonna edit this video, so if there's mistakes in it, they're just there. I'm not gonna edit it. This is real time. I'm actually having some issues with my gadgets, my editing stuff, so I can't edit this video. And I was kind of bummed out, and I wasn't gonna post a video because I was like, I had a whole vision, how I wanted to look, certain music that I want to have in the video, and I just had a way that I wanted to present it, but God was saying it's not about the visual, it's about the story and the testimony. So this is just real raw. This is just it. I'm not editing, I'm not adding music. This is the video. So as you can tell by the title, I am going to be giving my testimony on suicide, and hopefully I can help somebody else and just be light in somebody else's life. I don't want to rush this video because I got somewhere to be in like a few minutes, but I have to get this video out because it's a certain day that I want to post it, and like I have to have it posted by tomorrow. So and I have to work tomorrow, so this is the day that I had to do it. So I'm not gonna rush, but I'm gonna try and be as quick as possible, and I don't want to hold y'all long. So have you prayed today? First off, have you prayed today? If you have, either way, bow your head, we're gonna pray. Lord, I thank you for this day. Lord, I thank you for each and every person that's watching this video, God. God, I ask that you bless us and that you clear our minds and you clear our hearts and clear our thoughts, God. I pray that you will just forgive us for our sins, Lord, and thank you for another day. Thank you for another opportunity to get to know you, to get to love you, God. Thank you for not giving up on us, God. I pray for each and every individual that's watching this video, God. I don't know their life story, but you do, God. I pray that you will allow me to be a vessel unto you, God. I pray that you'll move through me. You'll speak through me, God. Say what you want me to say. Speak through me, God. Anything that's not of you, God, I pray that you'll discard it right now, God. I pray that you just bless me to just say the things that you need me to say. I pray that we can reach someone today if someone's struggling with suicide or anything, God. I pray that they don't see me, but they see you through me, God. Less of me and more of you, God. Man, bless each and every individual watching this video, God. And I thank you for this opportunity. I thank you for allowing me to do your work, God. And I thank you for just giving me these testimonies, God. And I just thank you and I love you. Oh, that scared me. And I appreciate all that you do, God. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Okay, so the heat came on, so that door shut. Anyways, so now that we have prayed, I'm just gonna jump right into it. I got my little notebook to keep notes of things that I wanted to make sure I didn't forget. So let's just jump right into it. I'm not gonna give you every single detail because not that it doesn't matter, but I'm just not gonna give you all the details. Okay, so I have attempted suicide. I think a total of 3 times in my entire life. Once when I was really young, maybe, I don't know, maybe 13, 14. I can't remember at what age I attempted first. But basically, what I did was I found some pills. Don't know what the pills were. Don't know what they were prescribed for or anything. And I just took them back to back. I don't remember how many I took. I don't remember, you know, like I said, I don't remember what they were for. But I took them. I took a lot enough to that it was supposed to affect me, but it didn't. Like, I don't know what the reason was for that situation, but God did not allow I had no reaction to the pills. Like, they didn't do anything. Like, I was taking them, and I was like, nothing's happening. Nothing literally happened. Like, I didn't have to go to the hospital. I didn't get sick from it. Nothing happened. It was just like, you know, it didn't work. So that was a long time ago when I was, I'm going to say between the age of 12 and 16, between that age. And then I attempted a second time, and I was a lot older. I also took pills as well. This time it was Lortabs, because I had burned my legs and had like second degree burns on my legs that I had to go to the doctor for, and the medicine that they prescribed for the pain was Lortabs. So I still had the Lortabs from that incident, and I want to say there were like, it was like a count of 30, you know. And when I actually burned myself, I only took one pill. I didn't take any more of them, so they were just laying around the house. And so I decided to take these pills, and I took the whole bottle, all except for like three. And I did have a reaction to it. I did have to go to the hospital, and they were asking, you know, if I was trying to kill myself. And I lied and I said no, because I knew what was going to happen. I knew they were going to send me to the psych ward, and I didn't want to go to the psych ward. So I was like, no, I just had a headache, and the headache wouldn't stop. So I just kept taking them. And of course, they all, the hospital, the nurses, the doctors, they knew, you know, that what I was trying to do. But again, they can't force you really to go to the psych ward. You know, they can't force that upon you if you don't want the help. I mean, you just don't get the help. But so I stayed in the hospital a few hours. They gave me something that made me vomit, so I vomited up. They did a lot of stuff. It's kind of a blur, you know. But long story short, so I did have to go to the hospital for that attempt, and then I went home like normal. The third time was more serious. I took sleeping pills the third time, and I guess I'm going to go more into detail on the third one. The third one happened 3 years ago, which is why I'm making this video, because now I'm officially 3 years clean of any sort of suicide attempts. I have not tried to kill myself in 3 years, so that's why I'm making this video. And actually, the day that this video is posted was the day that I tried to attempt suicide 3 years ago. So I tried to attempt suicide February 19th, 2018. So it's February 19th, 2018. So I'm going to go into detail a little bit about this one. I was living with my grandmother at the time. I had just left my first apartment to move back in with my grandmother to save money and I guess get on my feet, you know. I was working. Was I working? I believe I was working. I can't remember if I was going to school or not. And I was in a relationship also. And I just want to say that when I decide to attempt suicide, it's never really, you know, like, life is not horrible. I mean, there were things going on in my life, like I was in a bad space and I was in a bad place, but that literally was not what caused me to attempt suicide. When I attempt suicide, it's just at random. Like, I can be okay. It's weird. I can be okay. I can be fine. And it would like just drop out of the sky. Like, I'll decide, okay, I want to kill myself today. That's how it's always been. It's always just been like at the most random times, you know. And I say that to say because I remember me and my partner at the time were in an argument, got into an argument. It was just a horrible day, a horrible week. Like everything was just not going the way, you know, that I would have liked it to. And so I remember getting up. My grandmother wasn't home at the time. I got up, went to my car, and I went to the dollar store. And I bought a bottle of water and some Unicin, and those are the sleeping pills. So I bought the water and the sleeping pills. And I remember driving back home. I took three. As soon as I got out of the dollar store and I got back in my car, I took three of them, drove home. I instantly started feeling sleepy, right? Like, I instantly felt that. And so I got home and I parked my car and I just sat in my car and I took another handful, just drank water. Took another handful, drank water. Took another handful, drank water. And I was just sitting in my car and I was just sitting there. Like, I just was sitting there. And I remember sitting back in my seat like this, and I was just looking up at the sky, like at the clouds, and I was just sitting there. I don't know what was going through my mind. I don't remember the thoughts that were going through my mind, but then I had this moment. I think I had sat there about 30 minutes. I think I was sitting there maybe 30, 45 minutes. But I sat in my car because I noticed that my grandmother had came back home. So I stayed in my car. And like I said, I sat back in my seat and I was just looking up at the sky. Like, I guess it was like a high. I don't know. I just was sitting there and I was just staring up at the clouds. And then it was like 30 minutes, 45 minutes had rolled by and it clicked. And I was like, what am I doing? I don't want to die. Like, it's like something just clicked. And I was like, I don't want to die. And so I got up and I went into the house and I went to my room. I remember my grandmother was in the living room. I can't remember the conversation that we had, but we did talk. And I think my speech was starting to slur a little bit. I can tell that she knew something was up, but she didn't say anything. So we talked and then I went back to my room and I was in my room. I don't know. I had the lights on and I laid in my bed and I just started dry heaving. Like I wanted to throw up. I was trying to throw up, but I couldn't throw up. I'll go to the bathroom and I just couldn't throw up. Go back to my room and I was like, I just kept gagging and gagging and gagging and I couldn't throw up. And so I laid in my bed and I think my grandma, she knew something was up. So she came into my room and she said something. I cannot remember the conversations that we were having, but she said something to me. And then she said, she saw the pills on my bed, the bottle, and she picked it up and she was like, what's this? And I told her and she was like, you can't sleep. And I was like, no, ma'am. And then she said, how many did you take? And I said, just one. And so she put the bottle back down and then she left the room and she said, do you want me to turn the light out? I said, yes, ma'am. Something. It was something about when she turned that light out and shut the door, like my body just, like I started gasping for air. Like I couldn't breathe. I couldn't breathe. I couldn't, you know, catch my breath. And I could feel my hands and my arms going like really stiff. Like I couldn't, you know, clench. Or it's really weird what it feels like and your mouth just goes instantly dry. Okay, and so I started freaking out because I was like, oh yeah, like I'm about to die. So I got my phone, I called 911 and I went into the living room with my grandmother and I was like, I need to go to the doctor. I need to go to the hospital. I need to go to the hospital. And she was freaking out, but she stayed calm. But so we called the ambulance. And the lady, she's asking me all these questions. I'm getting frustrated. She's asking me just all kinds of stuff. And I'm just like, can you please just send help? And I give my phone to my grandmother. And my grandmother's talking to her. And I'm just like walking. I'm pacing outside because I'm like, I gotta stay up, I have to keep standing, because if I sit down, I'm gonna go to sleep. So I'm just walking, I'm pacing, I'm still alert at this point, but I'm like I can't catch my breath. And so I can hear the ambulance finally, and it was like they're just circling the block, like they couldn't find me, and I'm freaking out. I'm like, I'm gonna die before they get here. I can't breathe. I can't breathe. They can't find me. They can't find me. They literally could not find where I was. And so they finally found me and they sit me down. I'm like, and just started talking and, saying, why'd you do this? Do you want help? You know, do you want to live? They were really nice. They were awesome. And I wish I could thank them personally today. But so, make a long story short, I get to the hospital. And the rest of that is a blur. I remember, you know, basically telling the truth, you know, that I was trying to kill myself. And I already knew. They were like, okay, so we're going to admit you. So, long story short, I ended up in the psych ward for about 3 days where they prescribed medicine. Psych wards are, yeah. So, okay. That's that. So that's kind of like a brief little introduction of my very last suicide attempt. I kind of just want to go into detail on what I was feeling. You know, every time, you know, I thought about suicide or tried to take my life away, I felt, you know, like I was in a dark place. I felt worthless. I felt there was no purpose. I felt like, you know, this is it. You know, I can't continue to fight, you know, because it's just battle after battle after battle, and I'm tired of it, and I'm just like, I can't do this anymore. And so I remember feeling like that every single time I tried to attempt suicide. I remember just feeling so worthless, like I didn't have a purpose, like I was alone, like I was by myself, like there was nothing here for me. But I am here to tell you, you know, if I had not gone through any of that, if I had not felt any of those things, I wouldn't be able to sit here and give you this testimony today. Life is not easy. And I know that's so cliche to say, but it's not easy. And I'm grateful and I'm thankful for those battles, because I can sit here and I can talk to you today. You are not by far worthless. You are not unimportant. Like, the world may make you feel like you're nothing and that you don't have a purpose, but God has a purpose and a plan for your life. You are so important to God. Like, what person do you know on earth that knows how many hairs you have on your head or how many tears you have cried? And I failed to realize that even during those times where I was trying to commit suicide and trying to take my life away, I knew who Jesus was, but I don't know him like I know him now. But I knew who he was, and I knew that he was there. But, you know, he saved my life each and every one of those times. And I remember, like, my second attempt where I was, like, I was laying on the bed, and I was like, God, if you save my life right now, I will never do this again. And lo and behold, I turned around and did it a third time. But that was my third and final time, like, because I'm grateful for what God has done for me, you know. And I actually have some scriptures that I want to share with y'all, that I wish I had. So, let me see. I got my Bible right here, and I'm going to see. I know I marked it. Okay, so I wanted to share Psalms 41 and 10 for y'all. And it says, fear not, for I am with you. Be not dismayed, for I am your God. I will strengthen you. I will help you. I will uphold you with my righteous right hand. And that is Isaiah 41 and 10, not Psalms. But Isaiah 41 and 10. So, this verse has helped me tremendously. This scripture, I mean, it has helped me so much, because it says, again, fear not, I am with you. Be not dismayed, for I am your God. I will strengthen you. I will help you. I will uphold you with my righteous right hand. God is there through every single battle that you would ever have to face in life. God knows your ending. He created your ending before your beginning. So there is nothing that you can come up against that God won't help you with. There's nothing that can test you, tempt you, and try to destroy you that God is always there, and he's always been there. So if you feel like you don't have nobody else in this world, you have God. God is here with you, and he wants to help you, but you have to go to him. You have to build a relationship with him. Just call out to him. You don't even have to, he knows your heart. Sometimes all you have to do is just, when you don't have the words to say, just call on his name. Jesus, just call on his name, and he will protect you. He will love you. He will help you. You are not alone. It may feel like you're alone, but it's because you're not, you know, giving your time and attention to the right thing, the right person. So let God help you. Allow God into your life, because he wants to be in your life. He wants to love you. There's nothing you could have ever done. I feel like sometimes we think, oh, I've sinned too much. I've done so many wrong things. God doesn't love me. God doesn't want to hear from me. But he does. He really does. He uses broken people to fulfill his will. You know, have you ever noticed that? Like, none of us is perfect. It's the most broken people that God uses. You're not too broken for God. You're the perfect person for God, because I was broken. And I'm working. I was broken. Did you hear that? I was broken. I used to be broken. But he's working on me. And he'll do it for me, if he'll do it for little old me, I know he'll do it for you. So don't allow your brokenness to hinder you from coming to God. Because no matter how far away you've gone from him, no matter how far, you know, you went astray, he will bring you back, and he will welcome you with welcoming arms. But you have to want it. You have to want that for yourself. He can tell you all day long, you know, come to me, come to me, come to me. But it's up to you to take that invitation. It's up to you. He's not going to force it on you. He wants to be a part of your life. He does. And when I'm low, this scripture has gotten me through it all. Because fear not. What do you have to fear? What can anyone do to you? You know, you have nothing to fear, because God is with you all the time. All the time. Even in the midst of your sin, he's there. He's there. So don't let your brokenness hinder you from coming home. Don't do that. And I also had another scripture that I wanted to share. Hold on, I think I had a Bible study that, let's see. So the other scripture that I wanted to share is, I actually had to do a Bible study on this one. Yeah. So when I do my Bible study, I use the Bible app, and it gives me a verse of the day each and every day. So I did this particular verse, the one that I just read to you, which was Isaiah 41 and 10. I actually had to study this one on February 6th, and I used the SOAP method. And what that is S is for scripture, O is for observation, A is for apply, P is for prayer. So I had to break down this verse. Can y'all see it? So I'm going to read to y'all what I wrote on this day for this verse. So as we know, the scripture was, don't be afraid, for I am with you. Don't be discouraged, for I am your God. I will strengthen you and help you. I will hold you up with my victorious right hand. Isaiah 41 and 10. So what I wrote down was for observation was right hand with a question mark. And I said, why is there any significance in the right hand? And it was mentioned twice. So that question has not been answered for me yet. But apply, I wrote, I can stop being afraid when trials and tribulation comes, because God is with me through every battle. I shall not worry or fear. And I feel like that's something that we all should apply to our lives. Like when we come up against battles, why should we fear? Why should we freak out, you know? Why, what's the point in it when we have God? God didn't give you a spirit of fear. So don't fear. Don't ever feel like you're worthless. Don't ever feel like you have no purpose, because you have a purpose. You have a plan. And when you go to Jesus, he will reveal that purpose and that plan to you. So don't give up. And I'm officially late to where I'm supposed to be. So I'm going to try and hurry up. The other verse that I want to share with y'all is, let's see. There was another one. I think it was Psalm. I should have been more organized. I'm sorry, but. So we are going to go to Psalms 41 and 10. That's where I got confused at. I'm still memorizing my Bible, so give me a minute while I hunt down Psalms. I don't really use this Bible often. I use the other Bible. Yeah, let me get that other Bible, because I know that one better. Okay. Because it's smaller, I think. There we go. See, I know this one. This one, my baby, y'all. This is the study Bible, and it's just thick. Like, it's really thick. It has so much more information. So, I don't really be using that one. I use this one because it's just straight to the point. So, Psalms 41. When you have it, say amen. Psalms 41 and 10. No, that's not the right verse either. Where is that scripture? I had it, y'all. I swear I did. I know it's in Psalms, though. Maybe it's... Bear with me, y'all. Actually, y'all, I do want to say this while I'm thinking about it, but Psalms is my favorite book in the Bible. No, I take that back. The book of Job is my favorite story in the Bible so far. And I will talk to y'all more about the book of Job in chapter 2 when I upload it. But now I gotta find this. Okay. Yeah, I can't find it. Okay, y'all, I gotta get myself together because I gotta go. But like I was saying, the point and the purpose of this video is to let you know that you have purpose in this world. Whether you feel like it or not right now, you do. So you should not give up. You need to keep pushing, keep striving, because God got your back. God got your back, girl or guy. God got your back. You should not fret. He is the most powerful. I mean, the creator of this world, you know? Why are you fearing? Why are you giving up on yourself? He doesn't want you to do that. So continue to strive, continue to push, continue to move forward, because there's a purpose, there's a plan in the suffering and in the pain. It allows you to, like this, give your testimony, because had I not ever been through those dark times, had I ever not been through those dark moments, then I would never have been able to sit here and talk to you today. If life was always good, then we would not have a testimony. Then we cannot give glory to God. I am sitting here telling you, God has been so good to me. So good to me. I am truly in my heart, y'all. I'm at peace. And I am an emotional. On this journey, I have learned that I am extremely, extremely emotional when it comes to my journey with Christ, because he'd be like, you cry. I cry a lot when I'm happy. It just amazes me the things that God is capable of doing, not only for me, but for others around me. Like, I am sitting here and I'm telling you, I'm at peace in my heart because I know I have a purpose. Before, I never felt like I had a reason to be here. But God changed that. He came in and he made me see myself the way that he see me. And that's what you have to do. You have to pray to God. You have to talk with God. You have to, this right here, this is all you need. This has helped me and my relationship with God so much. Like, there's a whole world out there that you know nothing about. Like, there is a whole world out there that you know nothing about. Like, I knew Jesus before, but I know him better than I've ever known him before. So get in your word, get in your prayers, like talk to him. Like, he wants you to talk to him. Talk to him like he's just like a friend. Like, I'd be like, Daddy-o, like, I'd be like, Pops, what's good? You know, like, me and him have that relationship. We have that connection. And it'd be at the most random times. Like, just talk to him throughout your day, and he will give you everything your heart desires. If it's in his will, if it lines up with his will, he will give it to you. There's nothing. There's no prayer that goes unnoticed from God. Like, he knows everything, but you have to talk to him. You have to get to know him. Just love on him. He wants you to love on him because he will give you the love that your heart is desiring. If you don't feel love here on earth, he will give you that love. Because I feel loved. I'm so happy. I'm so at peace, you know. I feel like I have a purpose. That's my pops. Like, that's my guy. Like, he has really done amazing things in my life. And he would do the same for you. He would do it for you. Just turn to him. Turn to him. And I got one more scripture. And I know where that scripture is at. Hold on. This is the scripture I'm going to leave you with. So we're going to turn in our Bibles to Jeremiah. Where you at, Jeremiah? Maybe when I come back with chapter 2, I'll be able to tell y'all all the books of the Bible in order. And then I'm about to leave y'all with this. Look, I even highlighted it. So Jeremiah, this is 29. Verse 11. For I know the plans I have for you, says the Lord. They are plans for good and not for disaster, to give you a future and a hope. That right there, that's not my words. That is the word of God. For I know the plans I have for you. God has a purpose. God has a plan for your life. Don't give up on his purpose. Don't take the will of God into your own hands by trying to end your life, by trying to, who are we to do the work of God? You know, like saying, like, who are we to say it's our time up? You know, God hasn't said that. God said he has a plan and a purpose for your life. Not a plan. I know the plans I have for you, says the Lord. They are plans for good and not for disaster, to give you a future and a hope. And I hope that you will take that and you will study on that and let that marinate in your spirit, because that right there gets me through every single day. That gets me through every single day, because He has a plan and he has a purpose. He knows you by name. You're not just some random person. He knows you by name and he loves you. And I pray and I'm praying for you. I'm praying for each and every one of you that's watching this video. And I thank you so much for watching it. And like I said, just get in your word. Go to God. He's not mad at you. He loves you. He really does. And he wants the best for you. And he can give you that if you just go to him. And if you believe in him and if you trust in him, he'll give you everlasting life. Everlasting life. And I love y'all so, so, so much. And thank y'all for watching this testimony. I know it was all over the place, but I'm just letting God work through me. I'm just going with what he's saying. He said I don't need to edit, so I'm not going to edit. It's all going to be in this video. So just, I thank you for watching, and I love y'all so, so much. And I will be seeing y'all in chapter 2 if something else doesn't come up before that. But I will be seeing y'all in chapter 2. And I love y'all, and be blessed. So this is me in the future. I'm adding this into that video that whatever y'all, this is me in the future. And basically the video didn't go up when I wanted, this video didn't go up when I wanted to. I just had a lot of technical difficulties with my camera, phone, everything. And so I'm just adding this part in now. Today is the actual day where 3 years ago I tried to commit suicide. So today is my 3-year mark of being clean of suicide attempt. And so I just wanted to come in here and kind of document my thoughts and what I'm feeling. I'm truly grateful. I'm so grateful to have come this far, to have made it this far, to be able to sit here and talk to y'all on this day. Like, it means the world to me. And I'm actually getting ready to go to dinner in honor of celebrating. So I'm happy. I'm ecstatic. I'm at peace. And I'm just glad, you know, that what I was trying to do did not prosper. I'm glad that the weapon that was formed against me did not prosper. I'm glad that the enemy was not able to defeat me, you know? And I owe all glory, all credit to God, to Jesus, because if it was not for him, I wouldn't have made it this far. And so I just kind of wanted to get on here and share my thoughts and document how I'm feeling. And I just feel so, like, I feel good, and I feel at peace, and I feel so much joy. Like, I can't explain the peace that I feel in my heart. Like, I can't explain to you the joy that I truly do feel and the gratefulness that I feel. It's just an honor and a pleasure just to, you know that I was saved by God. And I guess that's all I wanted to say. And yeah, so I thank y'all so, so, so much for watching this video. Mwah. Hey y'all, so here I am yet again. I have went through so much to try and get this video up. There has been so many difficulties, so many things going wrong. And so I'm recording right now just to say, you know, usually when that many things go wrong at once, I give up and I'm like, okay, it's not meant to be. God don't want me to do this. But he laid it on my heart today that no, that's not him saying that he don't want me to post this video. Because why wouldn't he want me to give my testimony? Why wouldn't he want me to get my story out? The enemy will also try and shut you up. The enemy will try to get you to keep your mouth shut. And so that's the reason why I am recording now, because I'm learning, you know. The enemy will do whatever in his power to keep people from knowing how good Jesus really is, and to keep people from
knowing, you know, that Jesus is for them and can be for them. And so that's why I wanted to record, because I was about to just be like, you know what, it's not meant for this video to go up, but it definitely is meant for this video to go up, and it definitely is meant for somebody to hear this testimony, this story. So I guess this was more so for me, you know, so I have this to look back on. But this video is finally going up, and I want to say thank y'all so much for watching, and thank y'all just for who you are, you know. So if y'all enjoyed this video, give me a big thumbs up and hit that like button, and don't forget to subscribe if you have not already. And I think the next time I will see you guys is in chapter 2, hopefully, if nothing else comes up. So I love y'all. Mwah. And don't let the enemy shut you up. Moral of the story, don't let the enemy silence you. Don't let the enemy take your story away. Okay? Mwah.